We recently learned about how important it is to preserve plants in herbariums. But as we head into the digital world, we're learning more about how important it is to also digitize some of this. Joining us today is Dr. Mark Fishbein, who is the director of the OSU Herbarium. Dr. Fishbein, tell us a little bit. I guess you recently won a grant, is that correct, to help with this process?
Yeah, we're actually about 2 years into a National Science Foundation-funded project to bring these plant specimens to the world. And this is part of a regional consortium with many herbaria across the states of Oklahoma and Texas.
Okay, so probably about 50 or so herbariums, I'm assuming. Is that correct? Or?
Yeah, there's about 40 in our two states that are involved in this project. Plus, we are collaborating with the New York Botanical Garden, Missouri Botanical Garden, Harvard University, and other places that have many collections from our states.
Oh, wow. So you have these plants scattered throughout Oklahoma and Texas and other areas that you're trying to digitize. Why is that so important?
Well, there's several reasons. One is to minimize wear and tear on the specimens. So many people want to study our specimens or use them in teaching or in outreach projects, but they're not accessible to everybody. So by having them digitized and online, not only can many people use them, but for many purposes, they're just as good as digital objects as they are as physical specimens that can be studied.
That's amazing. So you're taking it global. Tell us, show us a little bit about this website, if you would, please.
Sure. This is our TORCH, Texas-Oklahoma Regional Consortium of Herbaria, data portal. And from here, we can search collections not only from Texas and Oklahoma, but from around the world on this platform. But for today, I just want to show you that we can study specimens specifically from our herbarium.
Okay.
And I'm going to use as an example the ground cherries that were the research focus of one of my predecessors, UT Waterfall. I'm going to enter some information, a genus name, into the search box here.
And is this something anybody can do if you're wanting
this
to?
This is the public face of the
okay.
portal. So anybody can search for by scientific name, by localities, by collectors, many different criteria. And when I do this, I pull up 1,738 records, which are the number of digitized specimens of ground cherries that we have in our herbarium. And because of Waterfall's work, we have specimens from Mexico and all over the world, one of the best collections of this genus in the world. Because the current digitization project is focused on Texas and Oklahoma specimens, let's take a look at one of these ground cherry specimens that was collected in Texas. And so when we click on the image, it pulls up the record, and we can see that the collector's collection number, the date, so the location, various information about the collection.
So this is that all the same information that you would find on the actual card, too?
That's right. So if we look at this more closely and we can zoom in, we can see that this information was transcribed off the label. Uh-huh. And we have this beautiful high-resolution view of the specimen, which can be studied almost to the same extent that you would get from a dissecting microscope, although for some purposes you'd really need to see the physical specimen, but you can tell for many purposes this would be completely sufficient.
Yeah. So obviously this is important not only for people to have access to all over the world, but also they're not physically handling all of your cards, potentially damaging them and that sort of thing as well.
Right. Yeah, to me it's those two things, increased accessibility, anybody in the world can see them, and then reduced wear and tear on the specimens. At OSU, we've imaged all of our Texas and Oklahoma specimens, and now we're in the process of transcribing them. So for, and other collections may be further along or not quite as far as we are.
I mean, it seems like a lot of work.
It is a tremendous amount of work. It's a 4-year grant to image and transcribe and find the digital coordinates for 2 million specimens.
Wow.
Is our goal. And so here's an example of one that we need additional work on. So we have the image on the specimen, but you see there's really no information. We only know that it's in Texas.
Okay.
So we would have a student worker in the herbarium or potentially a volunteer come in and access this image and then transcribe this information into our database.
Okay.
And in fact, that's the biggest chunk of work we have left to go.
So who all is doing this? You mentioned some students, mm-hmm. but that seems like you're not going to get that done in 4 years.
Yeah, I think just with student workers, we might not get to our goal. So we're looking for volunteers. There are some citizen science platforms. There's one called Notes for Nature mm-hmm. that we can send our images to, and then interested people, and there are many interested people around the world, can log into that platform and do transcriptions because they love learning about history or about plants, plant distributions or plant taxonomy. And we also are happy to have volunteers work directly with us at the herbarium.
Okay, so they can actually come in and do it that way or online, wherever you are.
So I think they can just contact me directly, and my email address is mark.fishbein@okstate.edu. And also, I can be contacted through our web portal at portal.torchherbaria.org.
All right, excellent. Well, this is a great resource to know about, not only if you're just interested in learning about plants, but especially if you want to help with this effort. So thank you, Dr. Fishbein, for joining us. And we love to check back in with you on this progress as it continues.
Oh, you're welcome. Thanks for coming.
We hope you enjoyed this video as part of our Oklahoma Gardening YouTube channel. You can also find even more videos on the OK Gardening Classics YouTube channel. And join us on social media for great gardening tips, photos, and discussion.